Hello friends, I am Dr. Ravindra Pal, teacher educator. In this session, we will be taking National Curriculum Framework for Teacher Education 2009-10. School education is directly influenced by teacher education. So if the teacher education is good, we will produce good quality teachers and school education is definitely going to be good. There is a need to revamp the teacher education in tune with the emerging concerns and imperatives of fast changing canvas of education, both nationally as well as globally. In this document, National Curriculum Framework for Teacher Education, the curriculum is divided into two stages. First is for the primary stage, classes 1 to 5. And here the rationale is to empower the teachers to gain greater insights into the complexities of society and the historical perspective of the developmental process. The role of teacher is changing. Earlier it was teacher, the knowledge provider. Then it became the facilitator of learning. It creates an environment for learning. And these days we say the teacher is a co-learner. So we have to provide a flexible framework for elementary education with ample scope for adaptation to local environment. Course content of primary stage teacher training program is, one is Emerging Indian Society. In this paper, the areas that they have included is the thrust identified in NCF 2005, rights of children, human rights education, values and their broad features, perspectives of educational, social, economic and political development in the country. So, all these are included in Emerging Indian Society. The next is the science and technology and related subjects which have seen fast developments in the past. So, all these new developments have to be included in the curriculum with the purpose of making the teachers aware of contextual realities in which they have to work. Then there are other courses, psychology of teaching and learning, wherein we teach child psychology and how children learn, health and physical education, education of children with special needs. And for this, these three papers have been specially included in the curriculum so that the teacher understands the learner, understands the needs of the community and the society, and the internal and external forces that affect the school, and internal and external variables that are operating upon the learner. Then there is another paper on school organization, class management, and important part is pedagogical analysis of all primary school subjects, how to teach, what to teach, how to assess. So, these courses are essential as they provide a sound base to function as a teacher. Training of teacher trainees in schools. This is integration of theory and practice in the training program, and it establishes a meaningful and interactive bonds between them. Teachers should have good knowledge, only then they can teach well, then they should know how to teach. So, correlation with the curricular areas of learning and external environment is to be established. Teachers need to tackle many problems in their profession, problems related to the school environment, to the child, to the parents and community. So, there are so many problems around them. They should know how to tackle them. And then important part of this curriculum is action research. This is included in the training to improve the way through which teachers address issues and solve their problems. The NCFTE proposes that states can include additional areas. Since India is a diverse country, so different states have their diverse needs. So, there is a scope to include additional areas for making course content relevant and region specific. Now, transacting curriculum is very important. So, theory, pedagogy and practicum, they all need to be integrated thoughtfully. In theory, the emphasis is on interactive, participatory and activity oriented approach using lecture cum discussion method, seminars, media supported teaching, tutorials, self study and practical activities, presentations by the students, teacher trainees. Knowledge of the content is given due importance during the course of training in all theory papers. Then comes pedagogy, which is about how you teach. It is a science of effective teaching, which deals with integrated content and appropriate methods of teaching. Pedagogical analysis of school subjects is an essential component of practice teaching. Pedagogical analysis helps a student teacher to become conversant with the objectives, why we are going to teach, then classroom management and evaluation strategies. A thoughtful integration of mastery of content, the insight gained through pedagogical analysis and the foundation courses, these help the students, the teachers in imparting effective classroom instruction. Practicum is again an important part of the training. Practical work is an essential component. It helps in internalize the theoretical concepts. Whatever they learn in theory, they practice in their practical work. It is planned on each aspect of theoretical inputs. Some of the practical activities are based on different school experiences during that period only, like work education, school community interaction, action research projects, and other practical activities are directed towards development of personality of students, which may also be taken by a prospective teacher. The role of teacher educators in curriculum transaction is, number one, continuous planning as per demand, as per the need of the school, the class, the student, the teacher training. This needs continuous planning. And then analyzing what is happening around, what is the need of the teacher trainee, monitoring and evaluating. Evaluation is the exercise done to understand, to determine whether we have actually achieved the desired objectives or not. It helps in determining the effectiveness of any program in meeting the objectives. The evaluation system should take into account the intended outcomes of the training program in relation to theory, practice teaching and practicum. We use different tools for evaluation. It depends on the objective to be assessed. We may have paper pencil tests comprising objective based questions. We may have balanced combination of essay type, short answer type and objective type questions, or oral examination, or sometimes performance, such as practice teaching, where performance of the teacher trainee is assessed. Participation in various activities measured through checklists, rating scales and observation schedules, etc. Evaluation can be internal by the college staff, external, or a judicious combination of both, maybe 20% internal and 80% external, or 40% internal and 60% external. Assigning grades instead of marks is a professionally sound step, as it minimizes categorization of students on the basis of marks, eliminating unhealthy competition among the learners. It also reduces societal pressures, leading to stress-free learning environment. So, this was about stage 1, where we were talking about primary education. Now, teacher education for elementary stage, yani classes 1 to 8. The rationale is the achievement of UEE, the goal of UEE. Since Right of Education Act has evolved from constitutional commitment of providing compulsory education till age 14, this age range covers a gradual transition from concrete operational stage of development, which was there in primary school students, to abstract reasoning process, because students of classes 6th, 7th, 8th are continuously entering into the stage of abstract reasoning. So, for that reason, even the teaching methodologies have to be changed. So, this demands transition of the teaching and learning process and a gradual change in the teaching learning strategies from one stage to another, matching with the maturity level of the learners. Here the course content is Education in Emerging Indian Society, which enables the prospective teachers to understand the demands that society expects education to fulfill. Elementary Education in India, Status, Problems and Issues. This paper helps promote the capacity to examine if these expectations can really be met. Then comes Psychology of Teaching and Learning. This paper enables the teachers to learn how to formulate your teaching strategies to promote learning among your students as per their learning needs and their learning styles. Then comes Health and Physical Education. This enables the teachers to plan exercises for development of sound. These will also help the teacher to deal with children with special needs. Then there's a paper on counseling and guidance to help the students if they have any problem of any kind. In stage 2 also, we have a training program which is very important. It prepares the prospective teachers to perform successfully in the pre-instructional, instructional and post-instructional phases of teaching. By pre-instructional phase means making the teacher trainees ready for the school experience program. Then instructional phase, which is in the school, and post-instructional phase when they come back, and full follow-up exercises. Action research develops the capacity of problem solving among the teachers. The pedagogical analysis provides an understanding of the complexity involved in the teaching of subjects at the elementary level. It enables the teachers to plan educational strategies. A critical observation of model lessons by the supervisors and practice teaching in the actual classroom situation prepares them to be effective and competent teachers. Internship in school offers varied experiences needed for working in a school. The teachers internalize educational value of the work and experience the dignity of manual work. The school community interaction promotes the interactive support between both teacher of the school and community and enables the teachers to evolve suitable pedagogy for children. The organization of education activities develop the capacity for planning and undertaking such activities. These are essential for the development of personality of the students. Transacting curriculum. Again, this is theory, which includes several well-designed approaches like lecture discussion, cooperative study, practical and demonstration techniques, self-study, as well as projects. They need to be adopted. The teacher should combine different strategies and instructional materials depending upon the topic. They should use supportive media, plan more hands-on experiences, organize field trips and visits, etc. Due attention is to be given to children with special needs. The curriculum transaction will have to be adjusted with the needs of students and locally available resources. Pedagogy here, during the process of teaching and learning, the existing transactional strategies marginally promote the capacity for independent study, self-discovery and self-study, which is much required. But they rarely seek prospective teachers' participation and remain mostly a one-way communication. Even the cooperative learning approach is taught through lecture in the classroom. The teachers are not able to practice the learner-centered approaches. So, to make the teachers competent to practice learner-centered approaches in the classroom, we should teach them in these learner-centered approaches. Only then they will learn. Only practicing in the class helps. Practice teaching is the weakest link of teacher education, but it can be strong if properly organized. The process of curriculum transaction needs improvement and enrichment. Pedagogical analysis of teaching subjects refines teaching and learning and transforms the teacher's performance. It develops competencies not covered by the method cum content approach. With the background of pedagogical analysis and model and demonstration lessons given by the teacher educator, the classroom performance is sure to improve if it is supervised in detail by the subject specialist. Practicum is, this includes work education as an important component of practical work, and is potentially, its potentiality has to be utilized by the teacher educator for developing certain qualities of character of teachers. The mutually supported school and community interaction helps the teachers to evolve suitable teaching strategies. The teachers are required to organize educational activities in school. They have to learn to plan, to organize such activities so that they provide opportunities for self-expression and lead to development of personality of students. They have to be trained for utilizing supplementary material, and this is very essential for promoting and accelerating learning among students. Here the role of teacher educators again is very crucial. They will be facilitating physical, social, emotional and aesthetic development of prospective teachers. Their creative and constructive potentials need to be fostered. Practical activities will help to achieve these aims. Students' new ideas, new creative, their initiatives, they should be appreciated by the teacher educator. It is therefore necessary to organize these activities on a continuing basis. The influence of teachers' personality and behavior has lasting impact on students. The teacher educator has to ensure that teaching becomes participatory, where all the students get a chance to participate, cooperative, activity-centered and joyful, so that the prospective teacher can also bring about similar modifications in their teaching learning practices, because we know the way we teach teacher trainees, in the same way they are going to teach students in their classroom. Teacher education has to inculcate professional commitment, develop competencies and make teacher reflective to deal with specific situations. They should be able to think of the problems that arise while teaching and then how to find suitable solutions. Again, evaluation, an important part of the teaching learning process. It has to be continuous, formative and comprehensive so that the teaching learning process is improved continuously. Systematic evaluation enables teachers to select proper teaching strategies and effect suitable changes in the curriculum process. The evaluation of the pupil teachers at the elementary stage does not differ much from that of the primary stage. And same principles apply here also. The same practices, the same tools can be adopted at elementary stage as well. So, success or failure of curriculum transaction is ascertained by evaluation done by means of valid and reliable tools. So, whatever tools we try, they should be valid and reliable. So, let's summarize what all we have studied in this lesson. First thing, we know that there is a need to revamp the teacher education to meet the emerging concerns and imperatives of the fast changing education system. Teacher educators at primary stage, they should train the teachers so that they are empowered through their training and they gain greater insights into the competences of society and historical perspective of the development process. All the courses like Emerging Indian Society, Psychology of Teaching and Learning, Health and Physical Education, Education of Children with Special Needs, School Organization and Pedagogical Analysis of Primary School Subjects, all these subjects are to be taken and taught through learner-centered approaches. Integration of theory and practice in the training program should be there so that there is a meaningful relationship between theory and practice. Action research is very important. It tells the teacher, it trains them to improve their teaching practice, improve their methods of teaching, you know, through which they can address local school problems also. Theory, pedagogy and practicum need to be integrated thoughtfully. The role of teacher educator in curriculum transaction as a planner, continuously planning, analyzer, monitoring the process and evaluating needs to be emphasized. Evaluation helps in determining the effectiveness of any program in meeting the objectives. So, evaluation has to be well planned, valid, reliable. In classes 6th to 8th, a gradual transition takes place from concrete operational to stage 2 abstract reasoning process. So, here also all the subjects that we include here, they should be taught through learner-centered methods only, so that the prospective teachers are prepared to perform successfully in the pre-instructional, instructional and post-instructional phases of teaching. Teacher educator has to prepare the prospective teachers for all these things. Pedagogical analysis, observation of their lessons and practice teaching, this all is required to be performed very meaningfully, and the teachers need to be guided well so that in our society we have all the good teachers, they teach well in the school and we move towards an educated and progressive society. Let's now summarize whatever we have studied in this session. First thing is that we all agree that teacher education program needs to be revamped, because the emerging concerns are changing, the education is fast growing, changing. So, all these have to be included in our teacher education program. So, that means we have to revamp the teacher education program. Then, teacher education at primary stage is to empower the teachers. Now, how can we empower the teachers? Through training inputs to gain greater insights into the complexities of the society and historical perspective of the developmental process. All the courses like Emerging Indian Society, Psychology of Teaching and Learning, Health and Physical Education, Function of Children with Special Needs, School Organization and Pedagogical Analysis of Primary School Subjects, all these papers have to be taught through learner-centered methods. Then we need to integrate the theory and practice very well so that the training program establishes a meaningful and interactive bond between the theory and practice. Action research is very important for all the teachers. They should be trained to perform action research so that whenever there's a problem, a local problem, they are able to address it through simple action research. Theory, pedagogy and practicum, all the three need to be integrated thoughtfully. Only then a meaningful teacher education program will emerge. the role of teacher educators in curriculum transaction is very important, because they need to do continuous planning, analyzing, monitoring and evaluating the system, the competence of the teacher trainees and whatever modifications are required, they need to assess and then do all the modifications accordingly. Evaluation helps in determining the effectiveness of any program in meeting the objectives. So, it should be an effective evaluation system using valid and reliable tools, so that we get the right feedback and do necessary modifications. In classes 6 to 8, since there is a gradual transition from concrete operational stage to abstract reasoning process, so we need to gradually change our teaching methodologies as well. We need to understand the child, give problems accordingly. Course content here is Education in Emerging Indian Society, Elementary Education in India, Status, Problems and Issues, Psychology of Teaching and Learning, Health and Physical Education, Counseling and Guidance. Again, all these subjects, they are theory subjects, but they need to be taught in a joyful, learner-centered methods, wherein the students are actively participating, they are doing cooperative learning, group discussions, they are learning from the media, and training prepares the prospective teachers to perform successfully in the pre-instructional phase, that is the planning phase, where they do micro teaching as well, instructional phase, where then they go to the schools for school experience, and post-instructional phases of teaching. The pedagogical analysis, observations of model lesson plan, practice teaching, internship, all these and the school community interaction. So, they all are important and they should be handled carefully in the school. That's all about this session. Hope you enjoyed it and hope you understood the National Curriculum Framework for Teacher Education well. See you next time. Thank you.